my dad would ask me, like, you know, how much would you make with a gig and stuff like that. I guess for me is to diversify the things that I do in the industry, to find side jobs that provide a more, slightly more stable income, or like when I don't get jobs, then try to create my own original work. Sometimes you feel like, oh no, what if the audience that we are reaching out to is not growing, you know? But to look on the bright side, you know that there are always efforts to get the mass public to watch theatre programmes, and so it's just hoping that the audience will grow as the years go by.
I really like what I'm doing, but at the same time, of course, there are nights when I'm in the balcony doing my work, my family are all here relaxing after work, watching TV. So I'll just miss those small moments, but it's okay for me. So my first priority when I graduated was to pay back my loans. And I know that I can't, for now, do my ceramics full-time. So I had to start working first, and I decided that maybe I should apply for a grant. I didn't receive the grant, so when I graduated, I brought home my clay, my tools, and I just started doing work on the dining table. I just realised that you don't need support from people outside. Please don't blame the people around you, that art cannot make it in Singapore. It's totally up to you if you're an artist.